Thanks for being here this afternoon. Look, it's going to be a little different on our study tonight. It's not going to be preaching really, but we're going to be in 1 John 4:1. And I said this morning, I was going to talk about Antichrist. That word, I want you to understand that a lot of our world thinks that when you say that word Antichrist, that it's very known, okay? But the definition of it kind of is an imposter. Someone that will change the doctrine of God. That someone's against God's word in doing it, okay? So a lot of times when people say, well, Antichrist is coming. Antichrist was John back then, and we can read. And John's the only one that really brings out this word Antichrist in the Bible. But John said that they were already in the world with him. And we'll read that here just a little bit. But, I mean, if you think about it, who is Antichrist? We have our world, especially the denominational world, the religious world, they make it look like it's not them. And if we're reading here this minute, we're going to see that me and you are obligated to know what's wrong of the Word and what's right of the Word. So we must consider, even for ourselves, are we right how we live our lives? Because we can put an impression on in our lives and come every Sunday and put a good presentation on. And then Monday, for the rest of the week, we can put on someone else and be an imposter. And you can say all week long that you're a Christian, but the words you say, the cursing, maybe Friday night and Saturday night, the drinking, or whatever the case may be, you better be very cautious, okay? We are representing the body of Christ. And give me understanding right here where I say something to you right now, okay? I'm not implying that me or you don't make mistakes. We are Christians, okay? So let's understand what I'm trying to say. I'm saying that someone that does not try to represent the body of Christ and be like Christ is who I'm talking about. So as we go through our study, I really want you to think about what Antichrist really is. And the only way you're really going to find out is if you know God. So here we go. 1 John 4:1. Beloved, believe not every spirit, but try the spirits whether they are of God, because many false prophets are gone out into the world. I want you to notice it says, try the spirits, test them, examine them, judge them. So when someone says something to you that you might want to think about, what are they actually saying? Is it from this book? Is it from the words of God? I've noticed a lot of times people put the presentation that the Holy Spirit works in our lives. Well, I want you to be very careful and think about this, how we use the Holy Spirit. See, people have the idea that I have the Holy Spirit and I'm saved. Are you saying you don't have God, the Father, and the Son? See, as a Christian, I have the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. I have all three. And you do too. If you're a Christian, you have all three. You don't have just one. And we have a society of religious people that want to separate and say, the Holy Spirit does this for me. They probably could be Antichrist because they don't have an understanding. See, if you're a Christian, you understand that you have all three. Another thing is, when people imply lots of things, when we see a false prophet here, it's really a false teacher. We use the idea of prophet as something that's not us. But we are all teachers, one way or the other. We're a true teacher or a false teacher. What are we to the world? We need to think about that and how we go about our lives and the way we do things. But there's a lot of instruction here, and we'll keep on. Verse 2, hereby know you, the Spirit of God. Every spirit that confesses that Jesus Christ is come in the flesh is of God. Well, this is a false definition of lots of people. They have the idea, if I acknowledge and I say that there is a Jesus Christ, that I'm saved and I'm okay. But that's not what this is saying. This is saying that someone that makes a commitment. This word confess is a vow, a commitment that I make, a promise that I made to our Lord and to the people that are around me, that I am going to be someone that's different. I'm going to be Christ-like. And I'm going to teach the words of Christ and understand it. See, lots of people say, well, you can't understand the Bible. If you can't understand the Bible, you can't understand heaven. And if you can't understand heaven, you can't be with God. Because the Word is not an author of confusion, God says. See, we have so many people out there saying so many different things, and they make it okay. But they're not making it okay. We have a way that we need to handle ourselves in the Word and teach it. So it says, well, you two wrapped up in the Word of God. This is a false teacher. Then you have other people say, well, God didn't say that you couldn't do that. This is a false teacher. God says you can do this. But where's it at? That's a false teacher. God's black and white. And we can see it with His words. So keep in mind, as you see people and talk to them that are spiritual, that they can be the Antichrist talking to you, even though they're talking saying, Antichrist is coming someday. They probably don't even realize it, but they are the Antichrist. Because it's someone that contradicts the Word of God. Verse 3. And every spirit that confesseth not that Jesus Christ is come in the flesh is not of God. And this is he that the spirit of Antichrist, whereof you have heard that it should come, and even now already is in the world. So John says it's already in the world in his time. People that won't make a promise and keep it. Someone that confesses says they're not walking that life. I can do whatever I want to. But you can't do that. There's a certain way that God's instructed us how to live and act. So when someone says, well, Antichrist is coming, you'll know this is a false teacher again. He's already here. It's not one being, it's many. It's anybody that doesn't live according to this book. Verse 4. You are of God, little children, and have overcome them, because greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. We, as Christians, can overcome of the world. They say all kinds of things, and they teach all kinds of things. But me and you, we can overcome them because of God. Verse 5. They, which are false teachers, are of the world. Therefore speak they of the world, and the world heareth them. These are people that sometimes you'd say are good people. Alright? These are people that you would consider, well, they're religious, they're okay. And that's what most of the world thinks. I've tried to have many discussions with people, and they have a way of acting pretty reasonable. But knowing the Word of God, they teach quite opposite. And so we need to be cautious on the way they think they say that you don't have to be baptized. Well, this is another false teaching, because we're commanded by Matthew 28:19-20. Jesus commands us to be baptized. But man says you don't have to be. These are people of the world. Verse 6. Word of God. He that knoweth God heareth us. He that is not of God heareth not us. Hereby know we the spirit of truth and the spirit of error. This one I want you to think about right now. We should know God. And the only way to do that is, like 2 Timothy 2:15 says, we're to study to show ourselves approved, rightly divided the word of truth. We need to be able to study it and recognize first we work on ourselves. And make sure that we are living as God's asked us to. And then if we're trying to live this life, other people see it. Well, they might see you fail sometimes, but you make it right. And you ask that I'm saved, that I made a mistake. Forgive me for that. I knew better and I did it anyway. And repent of it. You'll gain a lot of people's respect. But I want you to think about this. We have to know what error is being taught and what truth is being taught. John's really telling us something to think about here in verse 6, that we need to know what these people are saying. Is it fact or false? And a lot of people don't really know. I'm sorry, but even the Lord's people, a lot of them don't know. And it's sad that we all don't know the facts and be able to use the Bible and show why we do what we do. See, another thing about a false teacher is they don't want to talk about it, all right? They don't want to say, well, no, I'm not going to debate over the Bible or fight or argue about the Bible. That's not what God's saying. But that's what a false teacher does. He skims his way out while people, he didn't put himself in a position. He has to use the Bible to answer. And see, me and you are going to be judged and everyone else by this book. Revelation 20 is clear about that. And there's many people out there who are false teachers in our lives that are antichrists. And we need to take the ability to know and be able to teach those people. I'm not condemning them. They're doing that to themselves. But mine and your obligation to God is maybe share the Word of God that they might change. We need to think about that very hard and serious about what we're doing here. You know, why are we here? We come every week. But this is just a place that we study, just like we send the kids to school. This is what it is. And then we go out and use it. What do we take our kids to school for so many years if we're not going to use their education? That's what it's all about here. That's when we go every week and even Wednesday. We have an education that we can go out and use this. It's our job. It's labor for the Lord. It's a servant that we are. Or are we? Did we give up on our education? See, God requires education. And it's important for you, your family, your friends, even your enemies. We need to think about all those things. Verse 7, beloved, let us love one another, God. And everyone that loveth is born of God and knoweth God. He that loveth not, knoweth not God, for God is love. We have another term right here, love. Love is not always getting along with someone. And that's what a lot of religious beliefs have started doing now. They've got to the point that they're not going to talk about anything bad. They're going to say, look, it's a good day. We all have bad days. And we just focus on God. And they'll do a pep talk and make everybody happy until next week or whatever. But there's no education taught. There's games and playing. And we don't do that. And we can have fun doing it. But we just don't. We got to put God in our lives and the Word with it. I know I have friends, and there's not far from here, that there's no education taught of the Word really there. Because it would be controversial. Because they want every belief that there is. So they get all these beliefs in there, and they're scared to say anything about baptism. Or they'll say, look, you can be baptized if you want to. You can be sprinkled, or you can be immersed. And we can do it. We'll do it in about a month from now. Give you time to get ready if you want to do that. The convenience of the people. A place one time that the youth around here went, and it was a big youth rally thing, and we had went there and it got pretty rowdy, and went to the talked to some people, even talked to the elders about it. There's a few men that went and talked to them about what was happening, and they told us that there was too many different beliefs here. I'm talking about the Lord's church. Too many different beliefs to offend someone. So we'd rather offend you than those that are of the other faith or religion. I'd hate to be those elders someday. Y'all, I want you to be very cautious in the things that we do and say. And the world's out there full of it. And they just constantly keep on thinking new tricks to teach us how to get away from God. Y'all, know your Bible. Know why we don't have instruments. When someone says, well, it doesn't say not to. Yes, it does. If you look, it has nowhere in the Bible that says to use them. Number two is, God says in Timothy that He gave you all the instructions that you need to be perfect in His sight. So you're saying that God's a liar. God didn't put it in there, but you're supposed to do it. No, God didn't put it in there for a reason. Because He didn't want it. These are false teachers to me. It's like the Lord's Supper. First, we see a lot of times it says when the disciples came together, they broke bread. We know in Acts 20 verse 7 says the first day of the week. We see other places in 1 Corinthians that they came together and they broke bread even though they was doing it wrong. We have the indication that the first day of the week, every first day of the week is when we take it. But you have many people that will take it once a month, every 3 months, or Easter and Christmas. But where did they get their guidelines? They say people. That's not to be allowed with God. See, you're going to have to use the Word to defend yourself. All right? And defend God here on earth. There's so many things out there that people cut us down for doing what we do and serving the way we need to serve. And they just keep on and keep on and pound on us. Yeah, we've got to stay strong and fight against it and use the Bible to defend ourselves. And not worry about what everybody else is doing, okay? Think about that in our lives as we go through it, because it's tough. We all have a battle to fight. It's a spiritual battle. And I don't know when it's over, but you know, sometimes it feels like it can come any day. But I kind of hope it don't, because there's a lot more people out there that need God. And we need to be helping. And I want you to think about that. See, in Matthew 7, it talks, many are going to go to hell, and few that go to heaven. I'm not talking about three people. I'm talking about few far as the number goes. Because, and they think that they're even serving God right. But, they're not. Because they said they were not in the will of God. Why? Because these are the people that are changing the doctrine of God. These are antichrist. Now think about that. As you know, I don't know if it helped you or not, this little lesson, whatever. But I want you to think about it as you go through. When people start talking and bringing up things, a lot of people are these false teachers that we walk with every day. And just consider who they are. Not condemn them. Try to help them and teach them. And love them like God says. Remember, He said love people. And sometimes it's hard to love. So look, this is not what God recognizes as right. And give it to them. I appreciate you a lot. And I do thank you for being here tonight. You did show a promise to God tonight. When you came here and you worshiped God tonight. And try to know something about Him more. This is what God wants. And that's that love that God wants you to give Him. And teach one of us. We love each other. And I hope that's the case. Y'all know we're all a family. It's good to be together. So let's think about that as we go through the rest of this week. So, Greg, if you will, let's go ahead with the invitation song. Thank you.